gotta love like whoa. Girls gotta love like whoa. I kinda feel like it don't make sense, cause you're bringing me in and you're kicking me out again. I could've wrote down every thought I've been thinking to myself all this past year.
Glad you could join us on the bus, All Day Ready set, for a moment of cinematic whimsy. I'm speaking, of course, of the 1990 masterpiece, Troll 2.
As it says on the box, be afraid. Be twice as afraid.
From the opening score, Troll 2 establishes itself as a big-budget summer romp and circumstance. The dialogue flows like fine Egyptian silk.
What did they want with him? What did Peter do to the goblins?
And the special effects make George Lucas look like a bitch. Young Joshua hears goblin stories from his dead grandfather.
What are you doing still up, Josh?
Grandpa Seth is telling me to stop.
And when his family decides to take a vacation to Nilbog,
it's goblin spelled backwards!
He keeps having sweet, sweet goblin dreams.
Wasn't this movie called Troll? There's no trolls in it, just goblins.
Concentrate harder!
Is there a difference? The acting is literally the worst thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
That's not true!
Yes, it is.
You have to watch this movie to understand how bad it is.
I don't like this place.
It's terrible.
I don't understand.
Do you understand now?
There are a bunch of goblins. They're vegan, of course.
Purify the intestine.
But they still want to eat people.
They're eating her!
So they turn them into trees.
What, really?
I know, are you still with me?
There must be a logical reason for all of this.
Shut up!
And then things get weird.
Oh dear God, what can we do?
I found Troll 2 to be a very powerful social commentary.
You know, good versus evil often serves as a metaphor for the socialization of government by the vegetarians and hippies versus the privatization of commerce by the suits and bigwigs. This is no mere film about goblins. When you take a second to reflect, we quickly find that the real goblins are ourselves. Wow.
So it's kind of like Avatar.
And that's what made Troll 2 one of the best worst movies of all time. In fact, there's a documentary on its rise to cinematic badness.
Goblins don't exist. Goblins don't exist.
If the enigma of Troll 2 doesn't leave you thinking, how could this have possibly happened, then frankly I'd be a little concerned for your well-being. And that's what makes it a perfect bus movie. You've seen the best, now go see the rest.